Hello everyone, my name is Glenn Bartley and welcome to another video blog. This is the Bolivia edition. I just arrived, actually flew in this morning from Seattle to Chicago to Miami to La Paz to Santa Cruz, where I am now with my friend Doobie, who's recording. You'll see him later, I'm sure. And we're just in the city. We're at the Botanical Gardens. It's a wonderful place to get our trip started. Really easy. We're working on a buff-throated wood creeper that's around us right now. Who knows what else we'll find. But over the next month, we're going to be driving around this beautiful country and trying to find as many different birds as we can. So I hope you'll stay tuned and see what adventures lie ahead.
I've been trying to do it right. Hey! I've been living a lonely life. Hey! I've been sleeping here instead. Hey! I've been sleeping in my bed. Hey! I've been sleeping in my bed. Hey! So show me family. Hey! All the blood that I will bleed. Hey! I don't know where I belong. I don't know where I went wrong, but I can write a song. I belong with you, you belong with me, my sweetheart. I belong with you belong with me, my
three here in Bolivia, and we've managed to get our rental car, which is a huge step in the operations of navigating around this country. Navigating, though, always a challenge. We're on our way now to Lomas de Arenas, hopefully, and after that we're gonna head off into the mountains. So this is where the trip really gets going, and hopefully it's gonna be a good one. We are descending down into our next spot. Sorry about the video here, it's probably pretty bumpy, as is the road. Doobie, draw the short straw, so he's in the back. Vicente is our driver, doing a great job. Here we go. Down into the valley.
Alfombra, yeah.
Amarillo.
Ah, sí, de alto. Oh, man, there's...
Ahí voló. Cayó algo.
Oh, or péndola, sí.
Sí.
Okay, good.
All right, so I'm here in eastern Bolivia, down at a lodge. Really amazing scenery here, set in this sort of valley with all these mountains behind me. Maybe you can see. Hopefully you can hear me okay behind the waterfall. But what I wanted to show you was a little bit of a tropical bird setup that I'm working on here. There's some beautiful plush-capped jays and purplish jays that are coming in near the lodge. So I've set up some fruit and some rice and a few nice perches around it, and hopefully they're gonna come in and be able to get some good shots. So let me show you what that looks like. Okay, so here we have the feeder setup. You can see nothing fancy, a plank of wood, some fruit, some rice, a couple nice mossy perches, background, distant. What else is there to know? Let's hope some birds come in and land on it. This is the reality of nature photography a lot of the time, a lot of sitting and waiting. I've been sitting here by this feeder for about an hour and a half, no birds. So hopefully they'll show up soon. All right, so we're driving now through, let's watch out for this truck here. Driving now through dry forest habitat here. We've been were hanging out in a really amazing valley for a few days, and we were just in a bit of a lower area where it was nice dry forest. We had some good success with a few species last night, like the white-tipped plant cutter and nice black-capped warbling finch, a few others. So we're headed now to another lodge where we're hoping to photograph, watch out for the bumps. Hoping to photograph a few endemics, including a really beautiful species of macaw and a parakeet. There might be a few other things there, should be good. And then we're gonna be headed up into the mountains. So this is our last sort of lowland site before we head up into the mountains. And then things are really gonna change. From then on, we'll be doing more cloud forest and high elevation birding. And that should be pretty exciting, and the scenery, I imagine, will be spectacular. So stay tuned. If I don't get killed by one of these cars along this crazy road, I'll see you again soon. Alright, so we're here still in the dry forest of Bolivia. You can see all around us, it looks quite dry. Lots of cactuses, very open landscape. And we're at an amazing cliff site here where there's an endemic species, the red-fronted macaw, which is nesting on these cliffs, as well as some other parakeets and things like that. So it's been a really fun morning of flight photography. Trying to get these guys in flight is no easy task, but I'm going to give you a few tips that might help you in your own flight photography here. So a couple of things. If you're using a big lens, you've probably got a focus limiter on here. And so I've got mine set on 10 meters to infinity. So that means that the lens is not going to try to focus on anything really close, because the birds are never going to be closer than 10 meters to me. You're definitely going to want to use the servo focusing, or if you're using a Nikon, you're going to be an AFC. One thing you're going to want to try to do is pre-focus your lens approximately where you think the birds are going to be. That's going to help the focus acquire a lot faster. You're going to want to use a fast shutter speed, so you probably want to shoot wide open and use an aperture that will give you probably at least 1/1000th of a second. Those are a few things that might help you when you're trying to photograph birds in flight. And I'll show you some of the results here in just a second. What's going on, man?
We're getting kidnapped.
Oh no.
The Incas are kidnapping us.
Shit, we better go.
Let's see, man, before the trucks will start to try coming in.
Got a landslide happening here. I'm trying to pass before all these big trucks come. Doobie won't let me in the car. It's a little bit of a problem. So we're gonna see if we can pass here. Vamos, vamos, chico. Muy bien trabajo, señores. Bien fuerte.
I'm going to stay in 3 minutes.
Muy bien, señor. Bien fuerte. All right. Looks like it's looking promising here, as long as this guy doesn't get stuck. Let's see here. He does not have four-wheel drive. The Toyota Corolla is ill-equipped for this road.
But they know how to drive there.
Oh, a little slippery. The motorcycle looks a little worried. And we're on our way.
Vamos!
Alright, so we've ventured further up into the mountains now. We're in a totally different habitat than before. You can probably see behind me all the forest and the clouds rolling in. We're in the cloud forest. We're on our way towards the town of Cochabamba looking for some species. This morning had a great encounter with rufous-faced ant pitta, got some good shots, and also found a red-tailed comet, so that was pretty cool. Looking now for the black-hooded sunbeam. No luck so far, but hopefully over the next day or so we'll be able to find that guy. And then it'll be on the way to Cochabamba. See how we go. So this morning's main target is the Cochabamba mountain finch. And we're out in an area about 3,700 meters along the slopes of Cerro Tunari looking for this bird. We're actually out with a local researcher who offered to come with us and try to show us the bird. It's a rare bird though, we haven't seen it yet. We may not see it, but I did score this sweet hat which shows the Cochabamba mountain finch on it. So all is not lost. Hopefully we'll find the bird. Hopefully we'll get some photos. And even if we don't, it's a nice area to spend the morning. Okay, so we are now up in the high Andes, probably about 4,500 meters in the Puna area, in the highland grasses. You can see we're actually driving into a cloud right now. And we've just been nailing some high elevation species, white-winged yucca finch, Puna canastero, slender-billed miner, yellow-billed pintail, red-crested cotinga. It's been quite an afternoon. So now we're going to descend. Hopefully we get below this cloud, because otherwise... And we're going to go down into the polylepis forest, and maybe we can finish the day with a nice polylepis species. But yeah, it's been a good afternoon, and yeah, it's exciting birding up here in the Andes. Look at the view we have here. I mean... Here we have some local wildlife. Hola amigo, ¿dónde vas? ¿Cochabamba? ¿Quiere venir? ¿Qué piensas? ¿Hablas español? ¿Inglés? ¿Japonés? ¿Quechua?
Tal vez no gustas gringos.
Ok, chao.
Ok.
So, driving along here. And we've reached this market town, which is never good because that means it's a Saturday, lots of people, lots of trucks, lots of traffic, lots of dust. But hopefully we'll be through this town before too long and on our way to the Sunbeam. The last 2 days have been brutal. 48 hours, no photos. Yesterday, tried to go to what should be a great site and hit a big protest, a big roadblock, no cars passing the whole day, shut us down completely, no photos. The only good thing about yesterday was we met up with a local guide who gave us an exact spot, a very specific spot for the black-hooded sunbeam. And so optimism, running high, thinking we're gonna get this species, drive for 5 hours to get to the site, find the site, the exact site, no bird, no photos, not happy. But hopefully there'll be cold beer at the hotel tonight, because I'm definitely gonna need one. Having one flat tire is a problem. Having two flat tires, that's a bigger problem. Hopefully we can figure something out. Otherwise, we're gonna be stuck in Bolivia forever. What do you think about this, Doobie?
I love this country and I don't mind, you know, this spending of the rest of my life selling empanadas.
There we go.
Sounds cool to me.
I love how your glasses have full guy, Doobie. Alright, when you get two flat tires, you gotta sometimes figure something out. Here we are in a small village. We found a gentleman who can help us. He's put air in one of our tires. And we're gonna see if we can fix this one. So, ¿dónde quiere, señor? Aquí, nomás? Aquí es el hueco. So buddy, what's on the menu for today?
On the menu?
Yeah.
Como siempre, comida boliviana.
¿Y qué es comida boliviana?
Comida boliviana. Man, I'm tired of comida boliviana.
Arroz, pollo, nada más. We've got our friends here. Lots of friendly faces, hola. Should be a fine meal.
A fine meal. I'm not too excited about the upcoming meal.
Alright, so here we have the comida típico boliviano. Got some chicken. Looks fine, piece of chicken. Some rice, a little bit of pasta, a little salad, which I'm not going to eat. And some potatoes. So for a nice little lunch, it's probably going to be about $1 or $1.50. You can't go wrong. And top it off with some universally acquirable Coca-Cola. Muy rico. Sometimes in Bolivia you have to pump your own gas. Doobie, stop watching. watching for birds. Come on, we have work to do here.
I heard a parrot while doing it.
Get to work. Hey, despacio.
Hope I'm gonna get paid for this.
Dos bolivianos. Hey, watch, keep your eyes on the gas.
Hey, I hear a lifer. I must go. Can I stop in the middle? That it must be the black-winged parrot.
So I've been wandering through the markets here in Cochabamba, Bolivia for the last hour or so, and it's amazing actually how well organized this place is. Every section, every area has a different niche. So you've got the key maker here, the boot maker there, all the souvenir type stuff in one place, all the fruits in one place, meat in one place. Everything, despite the seeming chaos, is very organized. It's always fun to go wander through the markets, strike some bargains, and see what you can find. Now back to the hotel.
We blend in very well. No one really, they're not even aware of the gringos in town. That's good. I don't want anyone to the mustache.
That's right.
Yeah. I don't want anyone to run away with my 500.
Mucho tráfico. Alright, so it's been a really fun afternoon here shooting flamingos and Andean ivisets, black-necked stilts, tails, and spotted tails up behind here in this laguna. It's Laguna Uru Uru, if you can believe that. It's been a really nice afternoon, got some cool shots, some nice flight shots, and now the next stop is La Paz and some of the highland areas around there. Hopefully the Hooded Mountain Toucan is waiting for us there. So we just had a driving now onwards to La Paz. We had the classic South American experience. Cops trying to get money out of you, pull you over, something's wrong, you know, whatever it may be, and they're just trying to get money out of you. So Doobie and I have a classic foolproof system. Maybe Doobie can explain.
I mean, basically, you know, obviously after 7 years in South America, you pick up the language, you pick up Spanish, but when cops approach you, I mean, you don't speak una palabra en español. I mean, not even one word.
We can reenact. Señor, hay un problema de tu licencia. No hay triángulo. ¿Entiendes?
I'm sorry. Excuse me? What are you talking about?
No hablas español?
¿Qué es eso?
Works.
Only Japanese.
Works every time.
I speak only Japanese.
Alright, so I'm up here now birding I don't know if world famous is the correct term, but the famous world's most dangerous road, the Coroico Road, running from La Paz down to the town of Coroico. It's a very windy road and has earned the reputation as the world's most dangerous. Right now I'm up in the high elevation section. I'm about 4,300 meters above sea level right now, looking around for things like canisteros, striped-headed ant pita, hopefully something like an olivaceous thornbill or Andean hill star. But I'm about to look around here for a little bit longer and then go down into some polylepis habitat, and we'll see what types of things can be found there. Eventually going to end up down in the Yungas area and more of like a montane forest habitat, so there should be lots of good birds waiting down there. So for anyone who thinks that being a professional wildlife photographer is a glamorous job, let me tell you, it's not. It's pouring rain out, sitting up in the highlands, drinking terrible coffee, not out of a mug, but out of a Coke bottle that I had to cut in half. Got this guy beside me.
I think it's a great job, man.
It is a great job, but glamour, I don't think so. All right, so I'm here now on the world's most dangerous road, the Coroico Road, the old Coroico Road, and looking for the hooded mountain toucan, which would be amazing if we can find it. Already this morning, seen some really cool flocks with scarlet-bellied mountain tanager, hooded mountain tanager, blue-capped tanager, and lots of other beauties. But the problem, as you can probably see behind me, is that it's very foggy, which means it's not very good for photography right now. So hopefully it's going to clear. This will be lifting a little bit and be able to nail some good shots of a few of these really great high elevation species. Wow, what an amazing morning it's been. Not more than 5 minutes after my last video that I just shot, where I said we're going to go looking for the hooded mountain toucan. We found a pair of them. We're hopping around in the trees getting some shots. We got some okay shots, some pretty good stuff. We were pretty content. Went around another valley, and sure enough, another pair of hooded mountain toucans we found and got even better shots. So pretty spectacular morning to see one of the most beautiful toucans and get some pretty solid shots that I'll show you in just a minute. Sometimes when you're in the field, food is not top priority. So here we have our in the field lunch of champions. Some empanada from 2 days ago. Piece of bread also from 2 days ago. Can't go wrong with Snickers.
And I'm going to be the chef today. Elaine, I don't trust you.
Doobie's preparing some fine coffee here. Wow, Nescafe, top notch. It's going to be a good lunch. I'm pretty excited.
I'm not excited about this lunch.
I'm very excited.
Poco y después poco más y vas a sacar un poco. Pero yo voy un poco más bajo porque es alto para este. Yeah. Okay, bueno. Un professional photographer de Bolivia. Tal vez más en este derecho. Y o tal vez un foto. ¿Este es tus hermano?
Sí.
Okay, bueno, yo tengo una idea. Tú vas como 15 metros para allá y tu hermano vas a sacar una foto. ¿Qué piensas? Es una buena idea. Más. Yo voy a sacar una foto y tú puedes sacar la foto, ¿ok? Un momento. Ok, está bien. Y ahora, mira aquí y este toca este. ¿Puede ver?
Sí, wow.
Muy guapa tus hermanas.
Wow, qué lindo.
¿Quieres ver también? ¿Tú quieres sacar uno también?
Sí.
Muy bien. Yeah. Okay, guapa, ¿quieres ver tus fotos? Venga. No problema, amigo. Lo más guapa chica en todo Bolivia. ¿Qué piensa?
Sí.
Yo creo que sí.
This has been one of those epic days of photography. Started off with actually pretty low expectations because it was raining when we woke up. Wound up coming up here to this area that we've been in this Yungas forest. Nailed the hooded mountain toucan, mountain caracara, mountain wren. It's been such a big day, I can't even remember. But over 1,000 shots, orange-browed hemispingus, a few different mountain tanagers, white-collared jay. It's been definitely an epic day of photography, and we needed this because we've been hitting roadblocks and protests and a national census where we couldn't drive anywhere, flat tires. I mean, it's been a tough week, and today we were rewarded for our perseverance, thankfully. Hiking at 4,000 meters is never fun, Very difficult to walk at this elevation, but sometimes it's got to be done if you want to get the special birds that live up here. So hopefully you can find something. Beautiful scenery up here, not a lot of oxygen. Yes, riding the sheep. That one doesn't want to go across to meet all his friends over here.
The rest of the sheep are in
shock. Like, what the hell is going
on
over there?
Look at this guy. This guy is looking at them. He's like...
There you go. There's the big city of La Paz down there. I think 3 million people or so. And the highest, I guess, capital city in the world, according to the Lonely Planet. All right, here we are in Lago Titicaca, and we're at the first annual Titicaca Ping Pong Invitational Tournament.
I mean, the plan was to shoot Titicaca Grebes, but I guess this sounds better.
So we're gonna see. Doobie is a semi-professional ping pong player.
Professional?
I am.
But
I am not. Let's see how it goes.
Hey, they're very close actually. But it's a good thing, they're gonna play. They're probably used to it.
Alright, it's halftime ping pong tournament. 10-all right now, Canada versus Israel. Doobie is suffering because he's feeling the altitude here at 3,700 meters above sea level. He's looking a little fatigued. But he's got some good serves. So. Alright, so all in behind me, you can see this big lake, which is the famous Lago Titicaca. And this morning's mission is going to be to try to go out in a canoe and photograph the Titicaca flightless grebe. It's not the best weather for waterfowl photography, but hopefully we'll be able to have some success and find this critically endangered species. Alright, so I'm here in Lago Titicaca. And we've had a successful mission this morning for the Titicaca flightless grebe, a rare and endangered species. Sometimes in nature photography it pays to work in a team. So right now I'm the boatman, I'm paddling us around. I've got a fair bit of experience in boats. My friend up there is the shooter. He's doing a good job taking pictures.
I have a great driver here.
But yeah, it's been a good morning, a mission to photograph the grebe, and now we're on to the next adventure, which hopefully is finalmente, el black-hooded sunbeam. Well, after chasing the black-hooded sunbeam all over Bolivia, down bumpy dirt roads, flat tires, missing him, giving up, leaving the site, getting some new information, returning, more flat tires, missing him again, we finally caught up with him here at this site where there's a lot of these flowers in this valley. And basically we found a couple of nice males to try to photograph. Still not easy, but we're able to get some great shots. It's a really wonderful way to end this trip with one of Bolivia's most exciting, endemic, and most beautiful species, this sunbeam. And what can I say? It's been a great month here in Bolivia. We've seen lots of great birds, got some really good shots, lots of adventures along the way, and it's been a really fun time. So thanks for watching, and I hope you'll stay tuned to my website for more exciting adventures and new photos, and check back often. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.
Oh, hot sand on toes, cold sand in sleeping bags. I come to know that memories were the best things you ever had. The summer shorn, beat down on bony back. So far from home where the ocean stood, down dust and pine bone tracks. We slept like dogs down by the fireside. Awoke to the fog, we're all around us. The boom of summertime. Yeah. We stood steady as the stars in the wood. So happy hearted in the warmth, ring true inside these bones. As the old pine fair we sang. Just to bless the morning. Hats and on toes, coats and in sleeping bags. I come to know the friends around you. The world he'll always have. Smoke in my lungs, already echoed stone. Careless and young, free as the birds that fly. With weightless souls on. We stood steady as the stars in the woods. So happy hearted in the warmth, rang true inside these bones. We stood steady as the stars in the woods. So happy hearted in the warmth, rang true inside these bones. As the old pine fell we sang. Just to bless the morning. Here we grow, grow, older still how we grow.